Well, hello everybody. Been a little while since we've been on Facebook, especially doing any live cooking demos because we've been away over in Paris. So back home now and surprisingly in a jumper today. So autumn has finally hit and we awoke this morning and everyone wanted waffles. So before having gone to Paris, we've been following a little bit of a keto diet. And I went searching for a keto waffle recipe. Now, I get really excited when I unearth little gems like the one I have today. Here's my disclaimer. I have not made this recipe before. So those of you joining us today, you are on this journey, this keto-friendly, paleo-friendly, gluten-free, lactose-free waffle journey with me. So the four ingredients in our keto-friendly waffle this morning are just here in front of me. And if you're like me, you're gonna be blown away by what they are. I've got four eggs in a bowl. Hello, Sue Macklin. How are you, darling? Thanks for joining us. Four eggs in a bowl. To that, I'm going to add a half a cup of nut butter. Now the nut butter I had, I don't know if you can see that, it was just a beautiful, one of those Mavis nut butters, and it was, you know, almond seeds, sesame, all sorts of different things. I have read through the blog that I found this recipe on, and people have made it with peanut butter, almond butter, all sorts of different nut butters. So, hello everyone joining us. We are making for brunch this morning a four-ingredient waffle that is keto-friendly, paleo-friendly, gluten-free, lactose-free, low-carb, and hopefully bloody delicious. So, into my bowl, four eggs and half a cup of nut butter. Now, to sweeten this, we are going to use 1 tablespoon of stevia. So stevia obviously is a sweetening agent that is keto friendly. It is made, well, this one's a powder form. It comes in powder and also in liquid. And either form comes from a stevia plant and it's just dried and obviously ground up to form this powder. So a plant-based sweetening agent that is really good if you are on a keto diet. Now, I have also, the recipe called for half a teaspoon of baking powder. Now, alas, I have no baking powder. I had arrowroot instead. So it's a gluten-free thickening agent. I had a beautiful chicken curry last night and I thickened using arrowroot instead of corn flour. So I am going to just add a little bit of our arrowroot for thickening and rising, etc. Half a teaspoon, in it goes. And then we are going to just beat these four ingredients together into a really nice paste. Let's see how we go. Ooh. So four eggs, half a cup of nut butter, 1 tablespoon of stevia, and half a teaspoon of baking powder. And that's it. Apparently, the basis for a really easy, keto-friendly waffle. So, as I said up front, this is the first time I've made this recipe. So you can see I've got my little waffle machine next to me. I just bought it years ago online at better.com.au. And if you haven't liked our friends at Better's page, make sure you do so because they're weekly giveaways and competitions are fantastic. But it's just a little Breville waffle machine that I've had in my kitchen for years. So, beating it all together, I think you're going to get a nicer consistency using an electric mixer. So, dust off your electric mixer for this. I can see it all comes together. It actually looks like a flour-based waffle recipe, which I find quite extraordinary given there's no flour at all in this mixture. So can you see? I'll lift it up in a second. That all looks really well incorporated, no big lumps. Okay. I'll just show you what this. So that's your consistency. So it's kind of a waffle consistency. You know, if you made the waffle based on a flour ingredient.
So there you are. That's the waffle consistency to this recipe. Hello, everyone. How are you all? Hello, Tian. How are you, love? How's all in Adelaide? Sunta, down in Sydney. Shiny Allen, hello to you. Sharon Groves, Emma's. We're making keto-friendly waffles. So here we go. My little machine's been warming up. I'm going to add my mixture. So hopefully not too much, just enough. There we are. And we'll close it. And I want you all to hang with me because this is probably going to take about 3 or 4 minutes. So, you know, I want you all to see with me firsthand what this waffle looks like, because a really good waffle is going to be crunchy on the outside but nice and light and fluffy on the inside. So, you know, just really the two primary ingredients of this are egg and nut butter. So it'll be interesting to see. But I found it on a blog that had over 85 reviews, and I literally read every single one of those. And I would hazard a guess of the 85, at least 90% were really, really positive. So, you know, today what I'm going to serve this with, and this is a recipe if this works, and it's going to go into a new book called 4 Ingredients Keto. So I'm sure by now all of you have, you know, heard of keto, and essentially it's your low carb, high fat protein recipe based diet. So we followed it for 10 days prior to going over to Paris last week. And I'll tell you one thing, my nails got really, really hard. Isn't that interesting? So I lost 2 kilos prior to going to Paris, and then I put them promptly back on in Paris, eating my way through the streets of Paris and the amazing bread. Did you know in 1993 in France, the government, the national government, passed a bread law inscribing or directing bread makers how to make bread. They can essentially only use 4 ingredients to classify it as true, chewy, delicious French bread. So that's how good the bread in Paris, in France is. It is just phenomenal. So anyway, easy come, easy go in terms of the calorie. We're back on the horse though this week and watching what we eat and reducing our carbs. So carbs still very, very important in your daily diet. But of course, get rid of the carbs that are, you know, are zero nutrition or give you no nutritional value whatsoever. So they're your cakes, your biscuits, your donuts, processed sugars, etc., and incorporate into your diet, which you do on a keto diet, the carbs that are nutrient dense. So, you know, certain vegetables, certain nuts, you know, carbs from your avocados, your good fat, good energy foods like avocados, salmon, etc. So, you know, that's what we're doing. Oh, I think it's ready. That didn't seem like it was 3 minutes, was it? Okay, let's have a little squizzy biz. Oh my gosh. Okay, right, here we go. It's ready, the big unveil, beautiful people, our 4-ingredient keto-friendly waffle, which just also happens to be paleo-friendly, gluten-free, lactose-free, and low-carb. So here we are. Oh yes, I'm putting my fork in to get it out of my non-stick. Now, if you've got a waffle machine at home that isn't non-stick, what I would recommend is that you lightly spray your machine before you actually put in your mixture. But thankfully, my beautiful little Breville waffle maker is non-stick. Oh, here we go. Let's get it out. Oh, look at that. Okay, there's our waffle made. Okay, that is really nice. That is crunchy on the outside. Look at the inside, can you see that? Nice and fluffy on the inside. Made with eggs, nut butter, a bit of baking powder, and stevia. I cannot believe that. There you go, beautiful people. That is a 4-ingredient waffle recipe for the cookbooks, for your little homewritten journal at home. That is really good.
I'm going to serve it today with some fresh berries, which are the fruit on a keto diet that is good for you, and also some coconut yogurt. Now, interestingly, half a waffle is going to be about 250 calories. So
250 calories, about 3 grams of fiber, and 4 eggs, you're going to have about 14 grams of protein. So there you are. I'm going to serve it with some coconut yogurt and some beautiful mixed berries. Half a waffle. I'll take a photo of it and post it with the recipe at the top of this little post as well. So hello to Vicky Sherman from Tassie. Oh, you might be rugging up down there today. Majory Metcalf, hello from Flaxton, just up the road, Majory. What rainfall did you have overnight? We had probably about 80 mil, I reckon, in Pelican Waters overnight, which is just fantastic. It's so good to see. Let's hope it's going out west as well. Janelle Craig, hello, darling, all the way from Wagga Wagga. Hope you're getting some rain down there too. Pammy Bergman from Tassie. Oh, we got lots of Taswegians online today. Kathy McGregor, Appin, New South Wales. Kath, where is Appin in New South Wales? I've never heard of it. Oh, got to turn my waffle machine off. Hang on 1 second.
Voila, we don't want to keep it cooking, so I want to make another one.
Hello to Jan Macy from Sydney, Rachel Godfrey from Adelaide, Lee Delarie from Collie, Lee Delarie. Oh my gosh, that sounds like a song. Hello, Lee, beautiful name. Amanda Hooper, good morning, beautiful, good morning to you as well. Karen Pilecki, hello, darling. Hope your trip was wonderful. It was absolutely fabulous. Loved every second of it. Carla Howard, good morning from Somerset in Tassie. Well, hello to all of you. For those of you that have just joined us, I have literally just made a 4-ingredient waffle made of eggs, nut butter, baking powder, and stevia. Can you believe it? And this is what it looks like. It's nice and crispy on the outside, it's nice and crunchy, fluffy on the inside, and that's just how we like it. And what good timing is that? There is my phone. That'll be my mum saying, save me some waffles. Anyway, beautiful people, we're back from Paris. Look forward to joining you all over the next couple of weeks. More exciting recipes. And yes, the keto book is coming out. It'll probably be due out around May, June, July, somewhere. But we'll keep you posted with that. We'll put a beautiful cover of the front cover of the book up very soon. So better go answer my phone. Bye, everyone. Talk to you soon. Toodles.